Hello, and thanks for being with us on the program. And of course, you're welcome to the interview segment, to the chat segment. Today, we are taking a look at e-payment systems in Nigeria. And with me in the studio to discuss this issue is the Executive Secretary of the Electronic Payment Providers Association of Nigeria, Madam Olajide Rega. You're welcome.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me here.
And here on my right, I have Mr. Jibril Salauddin from CityServe. He's an e-payment provider too. You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. To what extent would you say user acceptance is, how is it rated currently?
I can tell you that more and more people are adopting electronic payment. You can think of that in terms of the value of what we do. June 2012, at the time we started, our POS transactions were barely below 300 million naira per day or per month. But as at May this year, we have over 750 billion transactions. You understand?
Yes.
So
yes,
there is a huge acceptance by individuals. Yes, we're still working to get more people to adopt electronic payment, but what we are seeing, we have seen a very big growth in the industry, and we are happy about that.
Okay, that's a good figure you have just given us. But generally, it is still seen like a lot of people are skeptical about adopting e-payment.
Yeah.
Okay, some of the reasons include that the safety, security of online transactions. A lot of people are still not confident that their data is secured, that that transaction is going to go successful without someone somewhere, okay, intercepting it. So to what level would you say the technologies we have today in Nigeria and regulations does protect the consumers?
Yeah. Okay, for consumer protection, I'll just quickly say that under the Nigerian Electronic Fraud Forum, which is a forum headed by the Central Bank of Nigeria with all the stakeholders as members, we've come up with an electronic payment arbitration framework, and that has been exposed. And people have made their comments, and we're going back to make sure that we put all those comments in perspective and come up with a framework so that people are comfortable that if they have any issues, they have a place to go to. But talking about fraud and the fear and risk, the fear associated with usage of cards, we'll find that I can say an associated fear. You know, when electronic payments began to gain ground in Nigeria, we were using magnetic stripe cards. And what happened is those cards are easy to counterfeit. They were easy techniques, phishing and smishing and all those kind of techniques that they could use in getting people's data and perpetrate frauds on their cards. But as soon as the central bank realized what the problem is, they came up with this thing policy that everybody who provides cards product must be EMV compliant. EMV is a standard for payment cards, and is the highest standard in the world. And I can tell you that in the whole world, Nigeria is the only country that does purely EMV for payment systems. With that, fraud cases came down by 95%. So we can say that we are just experiencing about 5% of fraud on cards. And we find that even those fraud 5% on cards that we are experiencing, most of them are friendly compromise. That is what we call this kind of fraud. We still have people who do not understand the importance of keeping their pins a secret. So they share their pins with their loved ones.
Yeah, and then
sometimes you even get them write a pin on a piece of paper,
wrap
it around the card, and use a rubber band all the time.
Yes.
It's like you're locking your money in a box with a padlock, then you put the key on the
box.
You haven't done anything.
Yes.
But we are educating people. The trend we are now seeing, which is common around the world, is a movement to fraud not present, card not present types of fraud. Okay.
Can you shed more light on that card not present form of transaction?
Yes, a card not present transaction is a situation where somebody said, I send you the details of my card, okay,
yeah,
and based on the detail of my card, you can actually use it on a payment platform.
Okay.
Okay. You see somebody who has said, I have a card that has some numeric numbers, and based on six or seven numeric numbers, I'm sending it to you because I want to make an hotel reservation. But my card is not present with you. All you just need to do is just to go onto a payment platform and put the details of that.
Yeah.
Now, what happened after using it to book my hotel? What happens to those cards, to those numbers?
Of that this I gave you.
That I gave to you.
Oh.
So those are card non-present transactions.
And those numbers can actually be manipulated, you know?
No, you give the correct numbers,
yes.
The number of your card and your CVV,
your PAN number,
and all of that. But so forestall that in Nigeria,
yes.
Because we know we are very smart. So, so we try to do things to forestall, you know, to forestall such challenges. We have moved to 2 or 3 level authentication.
Okay.
Yeah. So in Nigeria, for you to do a card not present transaction, most of the providers will provide you with a safe token.
And then we have the Electronic Payment Providers Association that you represent.
Yeah.
What gave rise to this the formation of this association, and what really are your objectives?
Thank you very much for that question. The Electronic Payment Providers Association, as the name implies, is an association of payment providers. They sit together, a common platform, to discuss issues of interest, common interest, without taking into consideration the commercials. We don't discuss issues of commercials. We discuss issues of common interest. We want to see how we can get favorable policies for our members, how we can get a favorable environment for our members so that they can get good business.
And now talking about acceptance, EPAN has something in the offing. I don't want to talk about it. I want you to say it yourself.
Okay.
Why are you focusing on the government?
Yes.
Why organize a summit or a conference and you are targeting the government when it comes to e-payment consumption?
Because you find that government is the single biggest spender in our economy. And then we have people in government who are not experts in payment. And like I said, payment system, electronic payment system especially, is new in Nigeria. So we need to build skills among this kind of people.
Thanks for being with us. We have just come to the end of this discussion. I hope you enjoyed the show and that you have just heard from the horse's mouth. So don't get troubled. Don't be skeptical about e-payment because it is working in Nigeria. If we could, within this short period, achieve the numbers that just told us here we have today, it then means we are making progress. So, if you have issues, you can reach CBN, reach your banker, reach your service provider, or better still, reach EPAN. Thank you so much.